Today, 7 golden rules that you must keep in mind when designing icons in Illustrator. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. The first golden rule in today's video on icon design is the preview bound setting, which is essential for web-based projects, but also really helpful for icon design too. So to demonstrate, I can press M for the rectangle tool and then click the artboard. I then just manually type in values of 200 by 200 pixels to generate a square. If I then take the line tool and create a line of 200 pixels, you can see that the square is actually larger than the line itself, even though I used 200 pixels for both things. This is because the stroke on the square is 20 pixels wide, and Illustrator doesn't compensate for this. But what we can do is press Command or Control K to open up the preferences, and then activate the preview bounds option. So now in the transform window, you can see that Illustrator now measures things from the edge of the stroke. This is very helpful when designing icons, and it's something that you want to keep in mind. The second golden rule for icon design is to use geometric shapes rather than drawing them yourself. So just to quickly demonstrate, I'm going to make the top part of the lock here. Pressing L for the ellipse tool would allow me to make a circle, and then I can flick the fill over to a stroke. By pressing C for the scissors tool, I can then cut the circle in half, and then later create rectangles the same size as the stroke. The reason for using geometric shapes to make icons is that firstly it's quicker than drawing everything out yourself, but more importantly, things are more precise and more smooth when you use geometric shapes. It is a lot easier to use the curvature of a circle than to try and draw a perfect circle using the pen tool. So wherever possible, try to use geometric shapes to create your icons in Illustrator. The next golden rule in today's video on icon design is to use the preview pixel mode. Now by default, if I zoom into the design in Illustrator, I can see obviously a crisp and a clean edge. This is because it's a vector design. However, if I press Alt and then Command or Control Y, I'm going to enter into the pixel preview mode. In the bottom left of the screen, I can zoom into 100% to see how crisp the icon is going to look on a screen when finished. So to ensure a crisp and a clean design, make sure your icons are designed on a pretty large artboard. One of the essential parts of designing an icon is to use a grid, and to activate the grid, come into the View menu and then click Show Grid. However, you can use a shortcut of Command or Control and then apostrophe. And the grid is so helpful for keeping your icon symmetrical and precise, so I do suggest using that on all of your icon projects. The fifth golden rule for icon design is simple, because icons should be simple. They can appear very small on a screen or even a print project, so they need to be basic and also minimal as possible. This is so that detail does not get lost when they're scaled down to a small size. Another quick and easy golden rule that you need to keep in mind is that you need to expand your strokes before finishing the design. If your icon is sent to someone, and then they resize it down or up, the strokes will not look ideal, so make sure to outline the strokes before signing off the project. The final golden rule for icon design in Illustrator is to make sure you lay them out perfectly once you're finished. Your final product needs to be showcased really well, so utilize the Align tool and make the rows and the columns evenly spaced out and neatly packaged. So I hope you know a thing or two now about icon design, and if you do want to keep expanding your skills and your awareness as a designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Like and share my videos on social media, and of course have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.